Welcome to this edition of Student Projects for the semester's class in Multicamera Television Production. Today I'll be looking at Katie Caldera's projects from the semester. One of the first assignments was for the students to produce a typical talk show up to 10 minutes in length. Katie and her partners formed the show UNT Underground, where she was the director of that show. The guest was Johnny Collins, a student dancer. Let's take a look.
Staying out. I've been hotter than vacation and laying out. I sat back and watched how it was playing out. They diss me, but running to take the same route. But no, they not Nikki. Wrist one, I say yes, my wrist.
Hello and welcome to UNT Underground. I'm your host, Jose Alonso. Today on UNT Underground, we'll be talking with Johnny Collins. Johnny is a dancer, a student, and a member of UNT's student-led dance group Choreo Block. Today, he's here to discuss what those various roles mean to him and where he foresees those roles taking him in the future. Welcome to UNT Underground, Johnny. We're so excited to have you here with us today.
Thank you. Happy to be here.
I would love to talk about you and your experiences first. How old were you when you began dancing?
I began dancing around 2018 when I first started out for Choreo Block, but I think it's always been like a thing for me, like since like seven or eight, really. I'll be dancing around my room and like listening to music and like, but at the time I really didn't call it dancing, it was just me like living.
Yeah, just living. It's been a couple of years now you get to be in your
own. Yeah, no, yeah.
It's so more than that. I personally want to know, how exactly does dancing make you feel?
It makes me feel, I guess the word I can put is, makes me feel very whole, makes me feel happy. If everything else in my life is like going wrong, then dance is going right.
Is there any advice you have for aspiring dancers watching this show today?
Yeah, I would honestly just say like keep going and don't be so in your head, and it's not as hard as you think.
Well, here on UNT Underground, we love to promote people who come to our show in any way possible. So where can people find you as well as Choreo Block on social media?
Cool. They can find me at Johnny_IM and then Choreo Block at just at Choreo Block.
Yeah, and we have that displayed right here if anybody wants to give it a follow. Yeah. Well, thank you so much for being here with us, Johnny.
Oh,
it's been
you.
A real pleasure having you on the show today. Unfortunately, that's all the time we have for today on UNT Underground. I've been your host, Jose Alonso. Thank you for watching.
I've been hotter than vacation and laying out. I sat back and watched how it was playing out. They diss me, but running to take the same route. But no, they not Nikki. Wrist on ice, say yes, my wrist bricky. If I leave, the game will miss.
Another assignment was to produce a news feature story. This was an individual project that needed to be filmed, directed, and produced. Katie gave us insight about the life of Lexi Wood and Broadway. Let's go to that interview.
Lexi Wood, 21, is a singer and actress who graduated from the American Musical and Dramatic Academy, or AMDA, in New York City. Her last year at the Academy was affected by the pandemic when students were given a week's notice that they were being sent home. Here, we have her story.
So COVID did really affect my last year at AMDA. I was in my last semester, actually, when COVID hit. I got to do my panel night the night before the shutdown happened, which is a night where you get to sing and perform for industry professionals. So it was really cool I got to do that, but then it really sucked because it was closed down the next day and I was told I had to get out and go. And then after that, classes were online, and doing theater classes online is a little tricky, but we made it work. It was very hard not knowing when I would perform next, and it is still really hard not knowing when I'm going to perform next. There's not a lot of hope right now, but I know that things are starting to open up, and hopefully it'll start to kind of get going and I can do something, but as of right now, there's not a lot of opportunity, so I'm every day thinking of that day. So what honestly got me into performing was my mom. She told me that when she was around 18, she actually recorded like a little album in a recording studio. She just did some Reba covers, but she still recorded it and she gave it around to my family, and everyone loved it, and she still loves to sing. So I was like, I want to be like my mom and I want to sing. So I would start singing in like the curtains to myself and have my own little jam sessions, and my mom really took notice of it and decided to put me in singing lessons. And then after that, it just kind of blossomed into theater, and here I am. Actually, how I've dealt with the pandemic as an actress has been more through my school. My school has a great alumni program, and they've been sending out different Zoom classes with like Mean Girls workshops and dance workshops, and trying to keep us active and keep us going through it. So it's been really nice to have those opportunities. And also, I've just been checking in to see if auditions are happening. So just keep checking and keep my body moving. I think the future of Broadway is good. I think that there's going to be a lot of steps to take before it can really reopen and be the amazing, beautiful thing that it was. It is really sad because a few of the shows did have to close down, like Mean Girls. Mean Girls was a major show that was happening, and it unfortunately is not going to be reopening after the pandemic. But there is a lot of shows that are still opening. There are shows that were supposed to open the week the pandemic really hit and everything shut down. And they are still planning to reopen. So there's definitely a lot of hope there. I think we're just going to have to really get that COVID testing going so that actors can get tested before every show. But I think it'll slowly but surely definitely reopen and go back to the way it was. My plans for the future are to go back to AMDA, but go to the Los Angeles campus and continue with my bachelor's degree in performing arts. So hopefully I can do that in the fall.
Final for this class was each student had to produce and direct a finished news segment, and that has been the segment you've been watching now. Congratulations to this semester's class for overcoming new challenges and coming together and doing a great job. Until next time, thanks for watching.